everyone, and welcome to the Cook to Flourish Kitchen. This is Robin Cook, and I am delighted to have you here today. We are talking about one of my favorite, most versatile foods in the kitchen, and that is spaghetti squash. This humble little football looking vegetable is useful for so many different recipes. And so if you have never tried it before, I first want to introduce you to the spaghetti squash and show you how to make it. So first you want to select a spaghetti squash, and I always like to look for one that has a lot of good yellow color to it. So this one here you can see has some nice yellow. This type of yellow color, or even a little bit brighter, is usually indicative that it's going to be a sweeter squash. Now, if you have one that's really, really pale all over, sometimes that can mean it's going to be a little bit weaker flavored, but it's still good. You can still use it. But if you want a super good one, try to find one that has that good yellow color. So then once you have your squash, you don't want to risk life and limb. You're going to wash it, and then you're going to dry it. And then instead of trying to hack through it when it's raw, you're going to take a knife and poke it once or twice really good, making sure that the knife goes to at least the center of the squash, and then bring it back out. And then you're going to put the squash into an oven preheated at 400 degrees for anywhere from 45 to 75 minutes, somewhere in there, depending on the size of the squash. So this one here took around an hour to do, and now that it's cooked, I'm gonna show you how to open it. So now we can safely open it. It's not nearly as difficult to cut into the squash once it's cooked. And then we see all the seeds inside, and then all you would need to do is take a fork, and we're gonna take out the seeds, discard those, and then you can scoop out the noodles or the spaghetti, see? So that's why it's called the spaghetti squash. Now, those of you that are spaghetti squash pros, I know you already knew that, but now I wanna show you some wonderful ways that you can use it in the kitchen. So of course, we can use it instead of pasta. It can make an amazing side dish. So here are some of my favorite ways to enjoy it. Plain and simple. If you're a person that does dairy, you could do some grass-fed butter right on top of this, kind of like you would a baked potato. Some real sea salt, some pepper, maybe a sprinkle of garlic powder, and boom, there you go. Already done. It's a wonderful side dish. Now, if you don't want to do dairy, no worries. Heavenly Olive Oils has you covered. They have all kinds of amazing flavored and infused extra virgin olive oils. So this one here, Tuscan herb, is amazing. You could drizzle some of that on there, salt, pepper, a little bit of garlic, or even just salt and pepper, or just this, and you're good to go. It is fantastic. Now, you could also do the heavenly butter flavor olive oil. That's another fun one too. I really like to use that one. So that is how you would do it. Ultra simple, is just using a wonderful olive oil or a high quality grass-fed butter. Now, let's move into a little bit more advanced ideas. Now, you could also do a nice infused olive oil with some fresh herbs. I just went out to my garden, I picked some rosemary, and it just smells so good. So you could do little sprigs or little minced pieces of rosemary, parsley, oregano, marjoram, whatever type of herb you have on hand would be fabulous. Now, another fun one that you might not know about is that, did you know that the herb thyme comes in different varieties, different flavors? Like, there's regular English thyme that's much more herby, but then there's also lemon thyme and orange thyme that are just really light and delightful. So this lemon thyme here, you can just pick off little pieces of the lemon thyme. It's so cute. And sprinkle it onto your squash, and then you could use some Persian lime olive oil on top, would be wonderful, or lemon olive oil, that would be fantastic too. So that's another fun way. You can also use cilantro. I have a little sprig of cilantro here. And cilantro would be great if you're having a Mexican dish. That would be wonderful with some coconut oil, some sea salt, pepper, maybe a little cayenne pepper or chili powder, and you can make it more of a Mexican type of a dish. That would be great. Now, also, if you have any leftover roasted vegetables, leftover roasted vegetables on top of spaghetti squash is very tasty as well. You could put a little bit of fresh basil on top. That would be wonderful also. So you could do roasted broccoli, roasted onion, roasted Brussels sprouts, roasted red pepper, any type of roasted vegetable on top of spaghetti squash, or mixed in, makes a wonderful lunch or a wonderful dinner even too. Now, you could use use that just by itself. You could put some garbanzo beans on there, or some baked chicken, or some salmon, any of that with your roasted vegetables, and your spaghetti squash would be wonderful. Now, you can also do kind of like a stir fry. Any Asian fans out there, you like Asian food? You could do some bok choy or mustard greens. These are some local mustard greens. You could slice these, saute them in some sesame oil or in some coconut oil with some shredded ginger, maybe a little bit of cilantro in there. And then you can mix that with your spaghetti squash. Instead of doing soba noodles or instead of rice noodles, use spaghetti squash as the base of that stir fry. And then, of course, you dazzle that up with some coconut aminos. This is the sweeter amino version. If you want more of a salty, traditional soy sauce version, you can use the Bragg's non-GMO soy sauce aminos. That would be wonderful, too. So you can do it Asian. You can do it kind of roasted vegetable and Italian. You can even take Swiss chard leaves here. Aren't these beautiful leaves? Wonderful magnesium content in them. You can slice them. You can saute them in some chicken broth, vegetable broth or coconut oil, and then you can toss that with your spaghetti squash, little sea salt, pepper, a little bit of garlic. Wonderful. You could do the same idea for kale if you're a kale fan, or arugula if you want some extra kind of a more bitter type of an herb. You could do that with the spaghetti squash too. We have some chive flowers here that could make a nice garnish on top of your spaghetti squash. Now, of course, we think of spaghetti squash, we think of spaghetti, we think of Italian, we think of pasta. So, of course, you could do some wonderful marinara sauce with no sugar added on top of your spaghetti squash. That would be wonderful. But if you don't want to do marinara, say you can't do tomatoes, no worries. You could do some sliced black olives, some fresh basil, any other fresh Italian herb. And then how about some grilled artichoke hearts? These are fantastic on top of some cooked spaghetti squash. Now, if you can do tomatoes and you want to bring a different flavor element in, you could do some roasted mushrooms, some grilled artichoke hearts, some sliced olives, some fresh basil, maybe a little pesto if you're really feeling adventurous, and you could do some sun-dried tomatoes. These are wonderful. Now, you want to get the ones that are packed in olive oil with no added sulfites, and then toss that all together with your spaghetti squash, and you won't even miss the cheese. It is delightful, just so good. The last one I want to mention is for Mexican again. You could do the simple version, which is your cilantro. Where'd you go? Oh yes, the cilantro and some Persian lime or coconut oil mixed in, or you could do like a kind of a salad or like a burrito bowl with the spaghetti squash as the base. Then you could put some black beans or pinto beans, whichever ones you prefer. You could do fajitas. You could do grilled onions and peppers on there. You could put any topping that you would do for Mexican food, and that would be very delicious. And then last but not least is you could do like a chimichurri or a pesto and toss that together with your spaghetti squash. So I don't even know how many ideas that was, and I'm sure that there's way, way more, but I hope that that gets your creative juices flowing so that way you and your family can enjoy this wonderful vegetable in many creative ways. God bless you, and we will see you again in the Cook to Flourish kitchen.